Spooky season is here, and I'm on a mission to read as many Halloween-themed books as possible by Halloween. And that is very ambitious of me, because I can't read that fast, but I'm gonna try. Let's pull out my Halloween reading list, which also can constitute as Halloween reading recommendations. First up is Trick or Treat. This is a point horror book about a girl who moves into a home where a woman was previously murdered years before, and then she starts receiving these phone calls, and I think the murderer is back because he was never caught. Then I have R.L. Stine's Halloween Night and Halloween Night 2. So the first one centers around a group of kids who play a prank on a girl by pretending to murder. They plan a murder, but it's supposed to be a prank, but I guess it goes wrong and somebody probably dies. And I don't want to read the synopsis to part 2 because I don't want to give away what happens in part 1, but the covers are just the perfect Halloween vibes. Then I have Halloween Fiend by C.V. Hunt. This is another incredible looking Halloween book. This is about a small, quaint town that is not all it appears to be. It's haunted every night by a creature the townsfolk refer to as Halloween. Okay. Once the sun sets each day, Halloween emerges to collect its treats, a small live offering from each household. The residents comply because no one wants to be the target of Halloween's tricks. The nightmare of residing in strange is nothing compared to the yearly ritual Halloween demands of the citizens on All Hallows' Eve. I'm in. And it's pretty short. It's a novella. So I think I can get through these four books pretty quickly. Then we have Autumn Crow by Cameron Chaney. He is a booktuber on here, The Library Macabre. His library is fantastic, and this is centered on the idyllic town of Autumn Crow. I believe this is a collection of short stories that are all centered around Halloween in this town, and I think it's perfect. This cover is another beautiful cover. I love Halloween covers. They're just so charming and they just really get me in the mood for Halloween. Then we have Dark Harvest, which I saw first from Book Skywalker reading this, and she raved about it on her channel. So I was like, I need to get this. And the cover, I love scarecrows. So the fact that this is a scarecrow on the cover, I was immediately sold. This is about the October Boy, I believe. It's a small Midwestern town where there's a legend, an urban legend known as the October Boy. He comes from the cornfields every year and on Halloween and kill someone, I think. And there's a group of boys who are waiting for him, for his arrival. Mina from Book Skywalker said it gave her Purge vibes, which I thought sounded interesting. So we'll see how this goes. I just love the cover so much. These covers are giving me life. Then we have Dark Harvest from Thomas Tryon. This is the same author of The Other, which is a classic horror novel I still haven't read, but this is about a couple who moved to a quaint village that has some dark secrets. And who doesn't love dark secrets? This one's a little thicker. It's almost 400 pages and the writing is pretty small, so I don't know if I should read this first, like get it out of the way, or save it for last, because sometimes when I read the really long ones first, it just kills my vibe if the book isn't that good. But I just get stuck in my head. I'm like, I need to read so many books. And I get pissed at myself for not reading so fast, so then it just makes me not enjoy it. I think I need to chill out and not think of it that way. I just need to make this a more enjoyable experience, but I wish I could read all of these in 1 month. It would just be iconic for my life. So then we have This Is Halloween from James A. Moore. This is a collection of dark tales centered around Halloween. Another beautiful cover. Short story collections aren't usually my thing, but if it's centered around Halloween, I think they can be fun. Hopefully. Then we have All Hallows Dead by Brian Smith. Another amazing cover. So this is, it's Halloween week in Willow Springs, Tennessee, and there's a slasher on the loose. And 25 years ago, a group of local boys did a very bad thing. We love that. And now a mass killer is leaving a trail of corpses and bloody pumpkins all over town. Thank you. Thank you. I will take it. Then we have The Legend of Sleepy Hollow. If you know me and you've watched a few of my videos, I've touched upon this, but I love Sleepy Hollow. I love the Headless Horseman. I love everything about that whole vibe. I think it's perfect for Halloween. I haven't read the book in a while. I read it in like years ago. So I found this recently, this copy at my thrift store, and I picked it up, and it's relatively short, The Legend of Sleepy Hollow is relatively short. This is actually a collection of short stories, so I'm just gonna read the Sleepy Hollow one. And also, Christina Henry is coming out with her book, The Horseman, which is a modern retelling of the Sleepy Hollow story, which I am so excited about. I don't have it yet, but you better believe I'm gonna go get it when it comes out on the 28th, even though I have all of these other books to read. Then I'm going to hopefully get into some other books that I think are more, I want to read a ton of haunted house horror. I think that's my vibe this year, is haunted house stuff. So the first one, which I think is perfect for this, is Kill Creek, which I believe is centered on Halloween, and it follows a group of horror authors who stay in a haunted house for a publicity stunt, and things obviously go wrong. I think that's a classic setup, so I'm interested to see where they go from here. A lot of people rave about this one, so I do have high hopes. So, and then another one that sounds, you know, very similar to this is Hell House, which is the OG haunted house horror about a group of people who stay in an infamously haunted house. And I think they stay at this house that previously belonged to a serial killer, or that might just be the movie. This house is haunted. It's a classic haunted house story. People have told me how terrifying this is, so I am expecting this one to really scare me. Then we have Burnt Offerings, which is a classic haunted house story about a family that moves into a home that has like a sinister hold on them. And I recently found this beautiful cover at Savers, so I'm excited to get to this. It is fairly like short. Oh, a receipt fell out. It would have been better if it was money. But yeah, so this is fairly short, and I'm excited to get to this and also watch the movie. Then I would love to get to Deadly Friend. This is basically a modern Frankenstein story. It's about a boy who's like really intelligent, and his friend dies and he brings her back, but she doesn't come back the same. You know, Pet Cemetery will tell ya, shit doesn't come back the same when you bring it back. So I didn't actually know this was a book. I knew the John Carpenter movie, the Wes Craven movie from when I was younger. It has some iconic death scenes in that, and I heard from somebody on Twitter that the book is really good. So I would love to get to it. It's just long, man. It's long and thick, and my list is just out of control this year. And then Psycho. This is a classic story. Hitchcock made it into a movie, and it centers around a weird guy named Norman Bates who has severe mommy issues, and he runs the Bates Motel, and things go wrong at this place. There's murder, mayhem, mystery, and what else could you ask for on Halloween? So I would love to get to this. It is only 172-ish pages, so it's not that bad. I would love to do a reading vlog of this as well. And also, if I had time, which I don't, I would love to get to Salem's Lot. This would be a reread for me. I think Salem's Lot is the essential Stephen King book to read for Halloween. It has the most fall Halloween vibes to me. This is centered on a small town where a writer, he returns to his hometown of Salem's Lot to write about an infamous house that is seemingly haunted, and things start going weird in the town. There's a vampire, and he's infecting people, okay? And I just think this is just the perfect Halloween read. I would love to get to it, but it is so big, and I'm not a huge rereader because there are so many books I haven't read that I would love to get to, so I can't see the point in rereading when there's new stuff I need to get to, but that's one I do need to reread at some point. And finally, I need to read this for the first time. I know, I still haven't read it yet because I'm kind of nervous. I don't know what's stopping me. I think it's just, this book is so iconic and it's so hyped, and I just am terrified of reading it for several reasons. Like, what if I don't vibe with it? What if it doesn't meet my expectations? What if I cry and it destroys me because it's about loss and grief and just, you know, all the things that just will, you know, make me bawl my eyes out. So, but this is the Horror in 24 pick for the month of October. I'm going to read it. How am I gonna fit it in with all these other books? Who knows? Who knows? But I can do it, right? Do you have faith in me that I can do this? Because I surely do not. I surely do not have any faith in myself. Please, please let me know what books you plan on reading this year for Halloween season. And let me know if you've read any of the books I've read, what you think of my TBR. I will catch you next time, guys. Happy Halloween. I hope you have a good one, and I hope you have a good reading season. Thanks so much for watching. I'll catch you next time. Bye.